In Cleveland, Ohio, a sinkhole brings a new challenge to the sewage management team.
A partial road collapse, shutting down traffic.
Some large pieces from the guardrail hanging on by a thread over the water.
Sinkholes occur when water has nowhere to drain and quickly erodes the underground rock. The topsoil remains intact, but unsupported until it suddenly collapses into the void. Sinkholes account for $300 million in damage every year, and this one has exposed several critical pipes that now dangle over a ravine.
That torrential rain, I think, was probably the trigger.
These pipes flow to a massive pump station servicing the entire Cleveland area. Any damage could create a domino effect, which would overrun the sewage lines. Josh and his crew are needed immediately.
Rain came through last night, a little erosion, ground washed away, collapsed. Now we out here checking the structural integrity of our pipe that runs over that culvert.
Go big or go home, right?
Yep.
First, the Cleveland crew checks for any damage that might cripple the sewer system.
So I'm just doing my initial investigation with our pole camera that uses a wireless feed to see what's actually happening.
Frank, get that light down there as much as you can.
The pole camera only has so much accessibility. A job like this requires the big guns.
Make a right. Once you get to Neroni, call me. I'll open it up so you can back the camera truck in, because we're going to have to run it out.
The CCTV truck uses HD cameras and remotely operated technology to safely inspect the pipes.
Okay, we're looking at our CCTV inspection hardware, basically like that. This controls the camera that we're going to be putting in the sewer. These guys are helping me out by setting up the camera.
Okay. It's clear coming through.
Hey, guys, we're ready to go.
But even with this remote tech, Josh and his crew are walking on eggshells.
Hey, hold that set.
Sinkholes can expand for days after the erosion begins, with some reaching widths of over several hundred feet. If that were to happen here, the damage done to Cleveland's sewer lines would be disastrous.
Stop.
An ROV will check for any damage to the sewer system.
Stop.
Before the team investigates the water pump station farther down the line.
We're looking for any kind of deflection or any kind of bevel in the pipe where there could be some issues.
The ROV rolls along for 100 feet as Josh scans the camera for any red flags.
Hear him moving through, he's probably getting kind of close.
Where is he? Where is our little buddy?
There he is, here he is. Hola.
So far, there's no major leaks or damage.
We're not losing anything out to the environment, so. We're off to a really good start.
But the pipes didn't escape completely unscathed. The sinkholes caused the exposed pipes to buckle under their own weight.
So it just needs a little support on both sides, a little, you know, nip tuck.
You heard that.
We see that we maybe have a little deflection, a little sag in that pipe right now.
The crew will call in a construction team to handle the repairs.
Pack it up, let's go.
Hey, little buddy, let's get you hosed off.
And while Josh and his team are finished at the roadside location, they still have one more stop to make before they can call it a day. The team needs to make sure the sinkhole didn't impact a critical pump station nearby.
This pipe here behind me, this 10-foot diameter pipe, this is our connection to the tunnel system. So right now, we're underground at the same level that our incoming sewers are. Flows that come in through the tunnel, past the isolation gate outside, make their way through, and they begin their trip up to the pump above us right here, and then sending it up near the surface to make its way to the treatment plant. And this station has the ability to pump out roughly 120 million gallons in a day with three of our larger pumps running. We're getting into the rainy season, so we really want to see where we're at, see if there's any maintenance items we need to address before these rains really start hitting us over the next month and a half or so. Stations like this and the infrastructure that's gone in place helps us to minimize overflows and maximize storage in the collection system. Because we built all this additional space to store these flows, we're able to capture all that rainflow that we couldn't treat properly, save it for the day after the rain event or hours after the rain event based on what the plant sees. We're able to pump that flow up and put it through the full treatment process.
The pump station siphons off 40 million gallons of sewage and runoff from the Cleveland area. The team will be checking its electronic gate, which stops any large debris from getting into the pump station. Any catastrophic damage to the gate could cause sewage to back up into the homes and streets of 3.6 million people.
The gate is actually just to control the amount of flow that goes into our pump station. Thank you. This is a very important sector of the pump station. We don't want that overflowing, which obviously is not good.
The gate sits here, roughly 22 stories below the ground.
We need a crane today to do an inspection. We inspect all the hardware, and then once we get down there, we inspect the gate and make sure there's no heavy debris, no logs wedged in, no metal pieces wedged in anywhere.
Stand by.
Todd needs to be incredibly cautious.
It's definitely dangerous. You're hanging from a wire rope.
Smile, Pete.
At 220 feet, one slip can be deadly.
All right. Woo! You know, you're just suspended there in the middle of nowhere.
Tighten your helmet. That's a big drop.
Yeah, we got a little light. We're all ready.
The shaft is the heart of Cleveland's sewage system. Severe structural damage could set off a domino effect of failures, pushing enough gallons of water into the streets to leave all of Cleveland ankle deep in sludge.
Right here, we're gonna be looking, make sure just all these fasteners are still connected to the wall here. So we'd like to just check everything and make sure there's no structural damage. And then once we get down, we're gonna do an inspection of the gate. Okay, go ahead and head down, probably another 10 feet.
Copy that.
Nothing can be left to chance. Every visible part of the gate needs to be given the once over. That means Todd dangling within inches of this giant vat of raw sewage.
Give me about 2 more feet, and then we should be good, about 2 feet.
See the amount of debris that gets caught on there. And the purpose of this inspection, make sure nothing is wedged or stuck in the gate.
As you can see, a storage tunnel. It's just about halfway full. Everything's looking good. You can wrap this up and head on back up.
Todd can breathe easy. Every nut and bolt are in place, and there's no erosion or clogs. The pump stations dodged a bullet and avoided fallout from that sinkhole. For major jobs like these, no news is good news.
Definitely can't be in a rush with this stuff, for sure. All right. It was good, good. Everything looked good. Nothing major, no hydraulic leaks. Everything was good. Nothing a good flush wouldn't take care of. Job well done.
We're all just hard workers. We want to see things get done, and, you know, so we all just do what we can do to make sure that happens.